What's going on, everybody? Welcome to G-Mai's World Podcast. Today, we're going to be talking about the Sunday night football game between the Seattle Seahawks and the Kansas City Chiefs. And first off, I got to say, I apologize to all the Seattle Seahawks fans because I went wild. And I thought that, you know, the Chiefs would not be their same old selves under Andy Reid and collapse in the second half of the season. But I don't know exactly what happened. Like, watching the game, it seems like, I don't know, because, you know, let me just go ahead and say this. The Seattle Seahawks had a very, very good system defensively to play against the Chiefs, and I noticed how far back, if you look at the game, the linebackers were playing so much, like, so far back, and then they had the safety help in the back to just prevent anything with Tyreek Hill, but they were attacking the ball so fast that they couldn't even run the ball. That's the first time I've ever seen that, because it wasn't like they can't stack the box because of Tyreek Hill, so it was a very difficult scheme, and they pulled it off, bro. Like, I don't, like, they're the number five seed right now, just chilling, waiting to see where they're going to play on wild card weekend. But that was the first time I've ever seen anything like that, because you couldn't go, you really couldn't go deep. But you could see that it was zone coverage, and Kelce was just sitting in the middle most of the time when he got the ball. You know, they got fumbles from the running backs. This is the thing, right? Kareem Hunt was probably going to lead the league in rushing. Obviously, we know a video was released from TMZ, and he was released immediately. I didn't want to say that his impact was that powerful because they were rushing the ball, you know, a little bit better. Like, if you look at the numbers, the other running backs, they kept up with what he was doing combined. But his influence on the team is obviously missed right now, because I don't know what else to point to. The defense sucks. We already know their defense sucks. And obviously, you know, this dude Russell Wilson going to throw dots and Carson's going to run it in for, you know, a last-minute plunge to make sure that they win. But I didn't expect this from the Chiefs right now this late in the season, and I expected them to be able to beat the Seattle Seahawks. Now, when you analyze the entire situation, we have to look now at the fact that the MVP, we've been giving it to Patrick Mahomes. Well, I can't say we, because some of you guys, you know, you've been thinking that Drew Brees was going to get it. Excuse me. You know, he's going to have over 5,000 yards and probably 50 touchdowns. I think they end the season against the Raiders or something like that. So everybody, like, that's just like a party. If it's not the Raiders, it's some other bum team. As far as the Chiefs go, so he should be able to get 50 touchdowns and 5,000 yards. Everybody that has ever done that has usually gotten the MVP. So we fully expect that the league might give it to him anyway. But this is really disappointing going down the stretch. Drew Brees himself also had some bad losses, but I don't know how to really react to what's going on right now, because we all know the Chiefs are in the playoffs, but like, they're limping into the playoffs. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is not something that you want to do. I've never really seen people like limp in and then really do anything. Like, you gotta show some fire towards the end. Now, they can end the season on a high note, you know, by winning their last game and seeing how that plays out. But this was a very, very tough loss mentally, you know, physically. You know, you go out there, you try to figure out what's going on, you play a tough game and you lose. You know, this could have some, you know, some bad effects on the team as a whole. Now, Russell Wilson, like, I've been trying to tell you guys this. The one thing I gave the Seahawks, Bobby Wagner and Russell Wilson, those are two top players. Like, both of them are top five at middle linebacker and QB. And it's amazing to me that they themselves are willing this team to win. Those two players that I just named, Bobby Wagner and Russell Wilson, those two players alone are willing this team to win. And it's unbelievable. Now we're going to talk about Patrick Mahomes. Like I said, this dude right here, I don't know what's going on, man. You know, I don't know if the O-line is not blocking properly. I don't know if he's not gun-shy. I don't know what's going on with him. But throughout the game, he was making some really, really questionable decisions, and it's making me realize, you know, the playoffs are a different type of animal, and that's usually why people go with those who are proven as opposed to those that, you know, are just hype, which I know a lot of you guys are going to say, yeah, I told you, bro, it was just the hype. I don't believe he's all hype. The dude is extremely talented. Like, hype doesn't make you throw over 5,000 yards and 50 touchdowns, which he should have by the time the season ends. I love me some Patrick Mahomes, boy. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Shannon Sharp. It's just the fact that, you know, I can't really blame Andy Reid for everything, even though it's his teams that usually does this when it comes down to when the playoffs are about to start. Well, I guess I can blame him. He gets paid a lot of money to be a head coach. I don't know. Somebody has to get the blame, but he's looked different to me. It's not injury. It's mental. Like, something's going on with this guy, and you can see the dog in the fight in Russell Wilson, but you don't see it in Patrick Mahomes. It's weird, bro. Like, I can't really explain it. Like, some of you guys are going to a lot of you guys are Chief haters. Like, I have to be objective. I can't just go out there and just be saying whatever, just hating on anybody individually. I have to talk about it prospectively the way I see it. Something is going on with him, and I don't know what it is. I don't know, you know, I don't know if Andy Reid is like, bro, you got to bring it down some, too many interceptions. I don't know what's going on. But with not having a solid running back that can hold on to the ball, fumbling, giving these guys the ball back twice, Conley fumbled at the end of the half. It's a lot of things, and in addition to that, they usually, you know, he had that big play, started the second half. He has that magic, but the team is giving the ball away. You can't give the ball, like, it's just common, you know, common knowledge. You can't give the ball away and win games, and it just looks like it's back to, you know, the same old with what's going on with the squad. The way Andy Reid, you know, his name, everybody talks about him. Like, if you look at any of the interviews, it's like, yeah, Andy Reid teams always collapse, you know, in December. And then you're looking at the games that they played over the last month, you're like, yeah, bro, Andy Reid, what are you doing, bro? Like, we thought you were over this. The beginning of the season, everybody could say the Chiefs is the most feared team in the NFL. You know, offensively, it looks like now, you see, every defense can't play like the Seahawks played, because I don't know if you guys analyze it like that, because when I'm watching the game, I try to analyze the way the defense is playing. So, you know, when I'm looking at it, I'm trying to figure out, like, what they're doing. I don't think every defense is going to be that fast to the ball the way that the Seattle Seahawks were last night. I don't think they're going to be able to do that. So I don't expect the Chiefs to, like, you know, people to just come in there and dominate the Chiefs like that, because I haven't seen it played like this throughout the entire season. Because that usually would mean, like, if they had a decent running back, like, if they had a Zeke Elliott, a Todd Gurley, you know what I'm saying, bro? Like, yo, hey, you know, Melvin Gordon, these dudes, Kamara, with the linebackers playing that far up, but they got two guys. Like, you know what I'm saying? They just got two guys back there running around. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's where I believe Kareem Hunt would have meant a little bit more to the team. So I thought they would be able to do something, bro. Like, listen, that now the loss of Kareem Hunt is really, like, something's going on. It's something going, I just can't put my finger on it. But it doesn't really matter about all that. They got 2 weeks to figure it out. Well, 3 weeks. They're going to probably get a bye, depending on how everything shakes out. If they don't get the bye, it's going to be, yo, they'll at least get a home game. You know what I'm saying, bro? And figure out what they're going to do. But still, don't get it twisted. They are one of the most dangerous teams in the NFL still. So the Seahawks kind of gave you guys the blueprint to beat them. You know, because let's be honest about it. If you can't take the top off the defense, the Chiefs are just the average team. Like that. That's the thing about it. This dude can throw the ball 6 million yards. So because he can throw the ball like that, that's what makes this team so dangerous. So if you take that one thing away, you take away that spark plug, Kareem Hunt. What happens? You got to find other ways to beat teams, and that's the issue. Where's your run game? You don't really have a run game anymore. Dudes are fumbling the ball every chance they get. You got idiot wide receivers that are just fumbling the ball, like in Conley, like. It's a joke right now. Everything is collapsing, and I know that, you know, Andy Reid is going to be that guy to blame. I don't know if it's all him, though. I want to say it's all him, but I can't say. Yo, bro, it's the reputation. His reputation precedes him. Like, he's known for doing it, so you have to blame him, but I think something's going on with the team, and I think it starts with the releasing of Kareem Hunt. I guess they really do miss him because I thought their offense was so explosive, you know, that it wouldn't really matter. They'd be able to, like, plug somebody in. Nah, this is not a Bill Belichick team. This is not Tom Brady. Like, this is just, you can't just plug anything in on this, bro. Like, you had something that was special there with Kareem Hunt, and that whole thing is gone. So as far as that goes, I don't like the Chiefs doing what I thought they would do in the playoffs, because this is dangerous stuff right now. Until they find a running back that you know, that just doesn't fumble the ball, which I don't think they'll be able to find before, you know, the playoffs start within the next couple weeks. I think they're pretty much a wraparoni with cheese. So we're going to go ahead and just say that, you know, I got to jump off the bandwagon right here. I got to just say, you know what? I thought they were going to go to the Super Bowl, but the AFC is very, very rough and tough with my Afro puffs. Like, listen, it's craziness going on right now. So if they keep playing like this, bro, like, first of all, the defense sucks. So I don't know where can I hang my hat? Their defense sucks, and dudes are realizing the blueprint is to keep two safeties in the backfield and wait for Tyreek Hill to go deep. So what do you do now? That's their offense. They have no run game. I have to get off the bandwagon. I still do believe that when he gets 5,000 yards and 50 touchdowns, that they should give him the MVP. But because the playoffs in the NFC have to go through the Saints, the records are pretty much, you know what I'm saying, they're both, like, dominant with that. We're going to have to figure out how the NFL wants to do it, but I think this is probably going to be the last year that Drew Brees can get it. Or maybe they let him split it. Maybe they do a dual MVP. Because you can't scoff at, you know, 50 touchdowns and 5,000 yards. You just can't. It's just something that you can't do. So I'm very interested to see the way that the MVP race plays out. But you can't keep losing and expect to get the MVP. It's just unacceptable. And I'm very disappointed in Andy Reid and the Chiefs. But congratulations to the Seahawks. You guys are going back to the playoffs after missing it last year. Can't wait to see how that unfolds. They're going to be a dangerous team, but I don't expect them to win anything. Until next time, one love.